Have you ever made a video with free video editing software only to be disappointed at the end when you realize there's a watermark that can't be removed from the finished product? That was my experience when I first started editing videos, and I don't want you to go through the same disappointment I did. That's why I'll be sharing the only three free video editors for PC without watermarks that you need to know about. And in addition to that, I'll be showcasing some of their most basic functions and features by editing a short video in each of them. But before we get into that, if you want to discover the best free software, increase the performance and usability of your PC, or learn new things you might not know about regarding computing and software, then you need to click the subscribe button right now. I upload new videos every week that cover these topics, and if you don't want to miss out on any new uploads, then you need to make sure that you're subscribed to my channel. DaVinci Resolve is unmatched when it comes to free video editing software on PC, and you won't find anything that compares to it. The features are top tier, with the most notable being the color grading tool that's even used by professional filmmakers, as you can see from the popular movie footage that's rolling on their website. You might be thinking, if this is what professionals are using to create the best movies, it must be perfect, but that's not entirely true. It does have some issues, which I'll touch on at the end. First, let's have a look at how it works by editing a very simple video. Upon opening DaVinci Resolve, I recommend clicking on the Edit tab at the bottom of the screen. I'll start by importing a simple video I created as an example to edit throughout this video. Next, I'll drag it onto the timeline so I can start editing it. I'm going to add some effects to the video, and I'll find them by clicking on the Effects tab at the top. There are a bunch of different effects, but I'll use the spiral wipe transition as an intro and the push transition as an outro, and change both of their durations. Next, I'll add a blur effect to the video, and I can also change the intensity and a few other things in the Inspector tab. I can also add some sound effects, and I'll add a chorus effect to the voiceover. There are some great pre-made titles in DaVinci Resolve to choose from. I'll be using Jitter here, and I'll change the text in the Inspector tool. Unfortunately, auto captions or subtitles are not a part of DaVinci Resolve, and you'll need to type your own. You can do so by right-clicking on the timeline, adding a subtitle track, and then right-clicking on the subtitle track and adding a subtitle. From here, you can edit the text in the Inspector tab and add additional subtitles as the video progresses, and you can change different settings like the font, size, position, and so on. In the Fusion tab, you can do some really high-tier editing and create different designs and effects. The Color tab allows you to do color grading, and DaVinci Resolve is one of the best programs to do this with, as it's being used by professional filmmakers as mentioned earlier. The Fairlight tab lets you edit the soundtracks, and you can add different sound effects and equalizers here. Let's export the video by going to the Deliver tab. I'll give the file a name and select a location to save it. I'll make sure that it's being rendered in the correct format and change the quality to high. If you've added subtitles or captions to your video, you'll need to click on the subtitle settings and make sure that it's exporting with the video. I'll go ahead and click Add to Render Queue, and then I'll click on Render All. And when it's finished, we'll have a look at the finished product.
This short intro serves as your video editor example. I hope you like it.
DaVinci Resolve is by far the best free video editing software you can use on PC. But the major issue with it is that you need a high-end computer to run it smoothly. If you don't have a mid to high-end PC, then you'll find the software unusable and very laggy. There are some settings you can change that'll make it perform better on older and low-end PCs, but I think you'll have a better time with the other editors on this list if you have an older or low-end PC. Clipchamp is a free video editor that was acquired by Microsoft in September of 2021 and is included in the latest Windows 10 and 11 update 22H2. Clipchamp is a really good option for beginners that also has a lot of great features you would expect and need from video editing software today. You can download it for Windows from the Microsoft Store, or you can use the online editor in your browser if your PC can't handle the Windows version. Clipchamp has a very simple mission, and that is to help everyone to become a creator of awesome video content. So let's have a look by editing a simple video. Upon opening Clipchamp, we can see a basic video editor user interface with the timeline and preview in the middle and functions to the left and the right of that. I'll start by importing media. Next, I'll drag it onto the timeline so I can start editing it. I can add some text to the video by clicking on the text field, which is already on the timeline by default. And here I can see all the different text templates included in Clipchamp. I'll be using the mirror title. I can edit the text that is displayed in this title and I'll change it to video example. I can also change the font and the size of it on screen. Another thing I can do is to separate the audio from the video file by selecting it on the timeline and clicking on Detach Audio in the Audio tab. This allows me to see the audio waveforms clearly to make precise cuts in case I wanted to do that. Clipchamp has a few free sound effects, but a lot of them are only included in the premium version. I'll just add a free whoosh sound effect by clicking on Add to Timeline, and I'll lower the volume and check if it's synced with the transition on screen.
Short intro serves as your video editor example.
The next feature I'll be using is the auto captions feature, which will auto generate subtitles for this video. I can also select different languages here, but I'll leave it on English and click on Turn on auto captions. When it's finished generating the captions, I can edit it if the AI might have gotten something wrong. There are a whole bunch of other effects and filters I can use on the video, but I'm happy with the edits I performed, so I'll be exporting the video by clicking on the Export tab at the top of the video preview. This will export the video project as 1080p, and it's currently the highest resolution you can select in Clipchamp. The video is exported without a watermark. Let's have a look at how it turned out.
This short intro serves as your video editor example. I hope you like it.
Clipchamp is good because it's easy to use and the user interface is easy to learn and understand. You can really do a lot with the free version of Clipchamp, but it is limited as most of the really great features are locked behind a paywall in the premium version. If you've never tried Clipchamp before, I highly suggest you give it a go. CapCut is a free all-in-one video editor for everyone to create anything anywhere. CapCut is such an underrated video editor, and the amount of features and free effects it includes are honestly insane for a free video editor without any watermark. CapCut is probably the best free video editor you can use on PC right now. It doesn't require a high-end PC and it's available for Mac and Windows, or you can use the online editor in a browser if you have a really low-end PC. Let's have a look at how it works by editing a very simple video. Upon opening CapCut, we can see a really clean and well-designed video editing interface. I'll start importing media by clicking on the Import button and selecting the video example. Next, I'll drag it onto the timeline to start editing it. Let's start by lowering the volume in the Audio tab to the right of the preview. Here, I can also see a lot of other edits I can make to the video clip, such as changing the speed and adding animations, among other things. Next, I'll add text to the video by clicking on the Text tab and then adding default text to the timeline. I can edit the text to the right of the preview and I'll change the text to your video example. I'll also change the font, size, stroke, and I'll add a shadow to the text. Next, I'll add some in and out animations to the text. I need some sound effects to complement the animations I just added, so I'll go to the Audio tab to the left of the preview and add some sound effects that are included in CapCut. Next, I'll add an effect to the video and I'll find a wide range of effects I can use in the Effects tab. I'll be using a basic blur effect by selecting it and dragging it directly onto the video clip. I'm able to change the strength or intensity of the blur with a slider to the right of the preview. Next, I'll add captions or subtitles to the video by clicking on Auto Captions in the Text tab to the left of the preview and click on Create. When it's done generating the captions, I can edit the text. I'll edit it to my liking and also change the color of the text to yellow. I'm ready to export the video, and I'll do that by clicking on Export. I'll give the exported file a name, and here I can also change a lot of other export settings and even render the project at 4K resolution. I'll render the project at 1080p by clicking on Export. The video is exported without a watermark. Unfortunately, I deleted the exported video and project file, but here is the edited video.
This short intro serves as your video editor example. I hope you like it.
CapCut is my go-to video editor, and that's what I'm currently using to create the videos on this channel. I strongly recommend using CapCut if you've never used a video editor before, as it's a great free program to start with and learn the basics of video editing. If you're interested in downloading and installing CapCut on your PC, then you need to watch the video that's on screen now.